Kunja Vihare Jagannatha Madhava Kunja Vihare Jayo Gopi Jana Vallabha Giri Varadhare Jayo
Gopi Jana Vallabha Giri Varadhare
Yashoda Nandana Braja Jana Ranjana
Yashoda Nandana
Braja Jana Ranjana Yamuna Tira Vanachare
Yamuna Tira Vanachare
Yayo Radha Madhava Kunjavihare
Yayo Radha Madhava
Gopi jana vallabha girivaradhare
Gopi jana vallabha girivaradhare
Yashoda nandana braja jana nandana
Yashoda nandana braja jana nandana
Yamuna tira vanachare
Jayo
Radha Madhava Kunjavihare
Jayo Radha Madhava Kunjavihare
Kirtan Srimad Bhagavatam ki jay Srila Prabhupada ki jay Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Narayanam Namaskritya Naranchaiva Narottamam Devim Sarasatim Vyasam Tato Jayamudiret Nashtapraye Subhadrishu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavater Uttamas Lokir Bhaktir Bhavati Nishtikim Yasyam Bhasuryamanayam Krishner Paramapurusher Bhaktir Utpadate Pumsasoka Moha Vayapaham Hare Krishna. So thank you very much, the devotees who have come here to participate in this message of distributing the Srimad Bhagavat. The topic of our discussion is Daksha curses Lord Shiva. So there is a saying, जब हाथी शहर में प्रवेश करता है तो क्या होता है? एक कथा है ना, जब हाथी शहर में प्रवेश करता है तो क्या होता है? कुत्ते भौंकने लग जाते हैं, परंतु कुत्ता भौंकने से हाथी को क्या फर्क पड़ता है? हाथी के सामने कुत्ता का क्या अस्तित्व है? अंत में भागने किसको पड़ता है, हाथी को या कुत्ते को? फिर भूखा तो कुत्ता, भागा कौन? भागा भी कुत्ता ही. So that is just an analogy of Lord Shiva, the most powerful living entity of the planet, and Daksha Prajapati, whose character resembles the greatest fall of the living entities. So when does one fall down? जीव का पतन कब होता है? तो दो कॉन्सेप्ट बताता है शास्त्र. क्या कहता है? अहम और ममेति. एक तो अहम को पैदा करना और ममेति, मैं और जिस वातावरण से मैं घुला हुआ हूं या जिस वातावरण से मैं चारों तरफ से घिरा हुआ हूं, यही सब कुछ है. यह था दक्षा प्रजापति का सिद्धांत, जो एक सामान्य जीव का सिद्धांत है. तो हम लोग का सिद्धांत क्या है? मेरा परिवार और मेरा ऑफिस है ना। ऑफिस मेरा परिवार को सुरक्षित रखता है, और मेरे परिवार कब तक सुरक्षित है? जब तक मैं सुरक्षित हूं। तो सारा संसार का सृष्टि इसी में आधारित है। और फिर शिव जी कैसे पर्सनालिटी के प्रतीक है? जैसे श्रीमद् भागवत गीता में कहता है ना कि नमे पार्थ स्थित कर्तव्यम त्रिश्लोकेषु कश्चन, कि इस संसार में ऐसा एक भी कर्म नहीं है, देयर इज नो वन एक्टिविटी दैट इज मस्ट फॉर गॉड, समथिंग इज मस्ट फॉर अस। और गीता सेज देयर इज नॉट इवन वन एक्टिविटी दैट इज कंपल्सरी फॉर गॉड, बट देयर इज नो एक्टिविटी दैट इज मेंशन इन द वेदास दैट आर ब्रोकन बाय गॉड। एन अदर साइड देयर आर नो एक्टिविटीज मेंशन इन द वेदास दैट आर फॉलोड बाय अस। यू सी द डिफरेंट, विच प्रिंसिपल ऑफ द वेदास डू वी फॉलो स्ट्रिक्टली? Anyone? कुछ है जो शास्त्रों में दिया गया नियम, जैसे शास्त्र क्या कहता है, एकादशी उपवास रखो, है ना, ये शास्त्र का नियम है। कुछ नियम होते हैं, कुछ निषेध होते हैं। तो शास्त्र से फास्ट ने एकादशी, नाउ वी डोंट डिनाई टू इट बट वी ऑलवेज फिगर आउट द ऑप्शनल वे, व्हाट इज एकादशी प्रसाद तो खा लेना, it is replacement. So this is the nature of living entity. And when it comes to Krishna, he perfectly, and we expect him, that we perfectly, that Krishna expect perfectly follows, although there is no need for him to follow. So in the scriptures, when the sacrifice of Daksha began, we know the first part of the sacrifice, what happened? Did it got completed? What did not allow the sacrifice to be complete? In other words, Vaishnava Aparad. Vaishnava Aparad brought the sacrifice to the end because Lord Shiva was offended. Even if the Supreme Lord is respected but the devotees are offended, that brings the end of everything. Because Daksha did not criticize Lord Vishnu. Who is the Yajna Purush? Lord Vishnu. Lord Vishnu is the actual enjoyer of the Vedas or the scriptures, or in other words, sacrifice. Now everyone is connected to it. Just like if there is a big party in the company, the employees enjoy it because you are the part of company. Isn't it? So according to the scriptures, the actual enjoyer of the yajna, the prime enjoyer is Lord Vishnu. The share given by Lord Vishnu is Lord Indra. Because Indra is the person that awards the material happiness. Lord through Indra does that. Because he is the king of heaven. Now, what had happened was Daksha Prajapati, that carries the concept of I and mine. The problem was that when he carried this concept, I and mine, he wanted Lord Shiva to understand that concept of his also. That Shivji, main hu aur mera hai. Mujhe manna tumhara kartavya. Ant mein, jab jivan mein bahut safalta prapt hoti hai, we are very successful in our life. We have gained everything. We expect that even God need to respect me now. Now when a person who is not materially mad goes to the temple, he feels that, oh God, it is my fortune that I am here. And when the person with lot of pride of wealth, without a devotion, goes to the temple, he thinks, oh God, aaj tumhara luck tha ki tumko donation mila. नहीं तो ये महीना का खर्च नहीं चलता है। He feels that God is lucky to have us. Now, what was the concept of Daksha. He felt you guys are lucky because I am performing a yajna. Not I am lucky because there is a personality like Lord Shiva here. This he never understood. So everything came to an end with his blasphemy. Now there are two things that the scriptures mention. When the Vaishnavas are blasphemed, there are three things that you need to do. Or when somebody or some sadhu has been blasphemed, the Shastra say you do two things, three things. First thing is, block your ears, don't hear that. Don't hear, because it won't affect anybody. Just like, say that there is a quarrel between husband and wife inside the house. You are not inside the house, you are at the door. Instead of walking away from door, you intend to put your ears towards the door and say, kya bol rahe hai dono? Yes, although you have not spoken anything there. So ultimately, they might stop quarreling and inside and will come and beat you in the head. बोले यहाँ खड़े होकर क्या दिख रहा है तू? अपना घर ऐसी मामला है, isn't it? So that's just an example. In the principle of offending a Vaishnava, even the person who may not be reacting but becomes the part of that. Just like the Shastra say, if there is a chastisement of the Brahmanas or the Vaishnavas, the Vaishyas, Shudras and Kshatriyas should not partake on that, because the level of Brahman is more. And the Kshatriyas, it is not their duty to decide. Just like nowadays we see, which is, you know, some of the temples, you know, other temples, they say, oh, certain people criticize the Brahman that was serving as a priest in the temple. If somebody, you know, 7-8 people got together, you know, oh, priest ke piche pad gaye. The Shastra say Brahman is punished by either the Supreme Lord himself or by the groups of Brahmanas. So here, Lord Shiva, who was blasphemed, first thing they should have done is block their ears, not listen, or they should go away. Second, if they are Kshatriyas or powerful Kshatriyas, that can counterattack. The person who is blaspheming should be punished right there. First thing, run away. Second thing, counterattack. Third thing, if that doesn't happen, and you have to be there, the Shastra say, you should just commit a suicide because you have committed the apradh. There is no worth of you living. So, although there were people in that sacrifice, people like Bhrigu, that were in the sacrifice, when all the associates of Lord Shiva attacked the yajna, Bhrigu, who was the priest of Daksha Prajapati, he chanted a mantras and he sprinkled some water onto the north side of the yajna, creating a groups of people who could protect the yajna now from his power. That was his power. That means killing the followers of Lord Shiva. So everything happened, the fight took place, everything came to an end, they went home. Then Lord Shiva begins to discuss with Sati. What has happened is, right after the yajna is being dissuccessful, Daksha plans it again. He plans that I am going to perform the yajna again, but this time Sati and Shiva, no invitation. They are the cause of disturbance here. Those were the people that did not respect me. Yes? Bolte hai na ki shadishuda beti se respect ka kamana mat karo, bas usko respect karo. Ki kam se kam ghar ka naam rahe wahan, ji ji karke. But Daksha, he was expecting from his own daughter. So Lord Shiva said, ki Parvati went and asked Lord Shiva ki, agar aap thoda sa, if you had just little bit, given a respect to Daksha, it would have been better. Papa ji, आपको थोड़ा सा उनका respect करने चाहिए था, बात हुआ वहाँ पर दोनों का. तो what does Lord Shiva says? Respect comes from the heart. Respect is emanated from love. You don't respect anybody that you don't love. Do you? Sometimes you may act right. You either you respect somebody from the heart and with love, or you act like you are respecting somebody because you are afraid of him. Isn't it? अगर इनको नमस्कार नहीं किया और सुबह सुबह हरे कृष्ण नहीं बोला तो हो सकता है ब्रेकफास्ट चला जाएगा आज का सुबह का. तो बाध्य से भी हरे कृष्ण बोल दो उनको. सो दिस इज नॉट ए पॉइंट ऑफ रिस्पेक्ट. रिस्पेक्ट डजंट कम फ्रॉम हियर. लॉर्ड शिवा सेज रिस्पेक्ट कम्स फ्रॉम हार्ट. ही सेड माय डियर सती हार्ट आई डोंट हैव बिकॉज आई हैव गिवन माय हार्ट टू नारायण. आई डोंट हैव माय हार्ट फॉर एनीबडी एल्स. एंड एज फार एज रिस्पेक्टिंग दक्ष इज कंसर्न आई डोंट सी हाउ दक्ष शुड बी रिस्पेक्टेड. वाई? जस्ट बिकॉज ही इज योर फादर एंड दैट यू रियलाइज लेटर ऑन. Should you just respect somebody because he is connected in a blood relationship, or do we earn respect? So he said, because I am inheriting Narayan within my heart, there is no question of me respecting anybody apart from Narayan. And I might artificially do it, but at that time when Daksha came within that sacrificial arena, I had Lord Narayan within me and I had already started my meditation, so therefore I didn't really notice that Daksha was actually there. So Lord Shiva makes the point. He said, I really did not notice. So ultimately, he noticed everything. Because he is looking at everyone saying, किसने हरे कृष्ण बोला, किसने नहीं बोला, किसने हाथ जोड़ा, किसने नमस्कार किया, किसने नहीं किया. ये सब दक्षा प्रजापति का नेत्र था, शिव जी का नेत्र नहीं था. सो ही नेवर रियलाइज दैट. ही सेड, सती आई डिड नॉट मीन टू अफेंड योर फादर. कभी होता है ना कि 5 साल के बाद तुम ससुराल चले गए, मेरे माता पिता को तुमने नमस्कार भी नहीं किया. तो ये तो होती है ना एक स्त्री से अपने पति से. जब ये जवाब पूछी तो शिव जी ने ऐसा जवाब दे दिया. तो फिर बाद में जा करके वो कहते हैं कि जो नमन शब्द होता है, जो नमति इति नमन, और नमन उसी को ही किया जाता है. यू रिस्पेक्ट, यू बाउ डाउन टू समबडी हु इज द सोर्स ऑफ एवरीथिंग फॉर यू. जैसे इन इंडिया और इवन हियर वी बाउ डाउन टू आवर पेरेंट्स. व्हाई? एक्सपेक्टिंग दैट दे आर एवरीथिंग टू मी. Say that those same parents break every rules and regulation and they have done nothing in your life that is good for you. Ab naman karenge. So he said, what has really Daksha done to me? Daksha Prajapati, I had no expectation of any desh from Daksha Prajapati. Did he expect anything? In fact, Sati had a problem. When Daksha Prajapati says, okay, take everything. I want to give lot of desh for the marriage. Then Lord Shiva said, घर ही नहीं है तो देश कहाँ रखोगी? अगर दक्षा ने देवी दिया, संसार का राजा है, he might give you lot of desh, but घर नहीं है. Today I am under one tree, tomorrow I am another, under another tree. Today I am in the mountain, tomorrow I am in next mountain. Where are you going to carry all these gadgets around? So Daksha, if you feel that I am a trustable husband, chalo tum. Just let's go, everything will be taken care. So then, Sati was thinking, now, okay, at one point he was a brahmachari. Brahmachari jangal mein rahe, ghar mein rahe, kya farak padta hai. But now he is a married person, he should have something for his family. So she is thinking this way. Why is Lord not Shiva having? And other side, because it is Parvati, or it is Sati. She could comprehend, Lord Shiva is not poor just because he has nothing. Because we have house, we have family, we have car, we have everything. Because of who? Lord Shiva. If he can distribute so much, why can't he have one? Anytime we want something, we immediately say, okay, we'll do Rudra Vishyakam today. Rudra ma khadvanga rudri. Eka vritti karenge aaj. Kal gyarva vritti karenge. Kyun? या तो नया घर चाहिए, या तो फिर कोई अच्छी बीवी चाहिए, कोई तो, या तो संकट आ हुआ है. जस्ट टू फ्री आवर सेल्फ फ्रॉम दिस प्रॉब्लम वी टेक शेल्टर ऑफ लॉर्ड शिवा. नाउ सती थिंग्स इट कैंट बी दैट बिकॉज लॉर्ड शिवा इज सो पोअर जस्ट बिकॉज ही कैंट अर्न एनीथिंग. बट राइट, लॉर्ड शिवा टेल्स अबाउट टू सती. ही सेज द मटेरियलिस्टिक पीपल हु आर वर्किंग डे एंड नाइट just to gratify their senses. This is the word of Lord Shiva. Because most of us, to become happy, we work day and night, making plan. When we are working, we are working. And when we are not working, what are we doing? Dreaming. Because we worked whole day. Now our brain does not allow us to sleep. It is set up that way. Now, when those type of hard-working people, Lord Shiva is talking about this, see somebody who has no job, okay, but he has the best place to live, best food to eat, and best car to ride on, he naturally becomes envious of him. Lord Shiva is saying this. Because nobody nahi, kuch nahi hai, kya nahi hai, bas sab kuch mehengai chadde rehta hai, kya hai iska kamal? So he said, only the problem with Daksha is that he is envious of me. Why? Why is Daksha envious of Lord Shiva? Shiva ji ke paas sab kuch hai, shanti bhi hai. Hai na? Itna jhanjhat karne ke baad, after so much disturbance and blaspheming, Lord Shiva is still meditating. Koi problem nahi hai. और दक्षा प्रजापति ऊपर नीचे नाचते ही रह रहा है, क्यों? ये क्यों नहीं उठा मेरे लिए, क्यों नहीं उठा मेरे लिए? अगर ये नहीं उठा तो अभी मैं उठता हूँ अभी फिर. सो दैट्स व्हाई ही इज डांसिंग राइट देयर. व्हाई? बिकॉज़ ही हैज अ बिग एक्सपेक्टेशन इन लाइफ. लॉर्ड शिवा नथिंग. सो लॉर्ड शिवा सेज द रूट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम इज हियर दैट दक्षा इज एनवियस ऑफ मी हु इज कंप्लीटली सैटिस्फाइड. सो देयरफॉर माई डियर सती, व्हाई वरीड अबाउट ऑल दैट? सो सती से रोके पति देव नमस्कार, आपसे कौन क्या बोल सकता है, आप सब कुछ जानने वाले हैं. सो सती गोस विथ हर लाइफ. बट वन डे व्हेन सती इज गोइंग आउट फ्रॉम हर होम टू फेच सम फ्लावर एंड सम वाटर फ्रॉम द गंगा फॉर द डेली एक्टिविटीज ऑफ लॉर्ड शिवा, देन शी सीज अप्सरास फ्लाइंग थ्रू द स्काई, इंद्रास वाइफ सची, द वाइफ ऑफ सोमा, द वाइफ ऑफ अदर डेमिगॉड्स, दे आर गोइंग ब्यूटीफुल ड्रेस्ड विद द बेस्ट ज्वेलरीज. शादी का सब गहने को वही समय में पहन लिया था सबने. एवरी वन वॉज नाइसली डेकोरेटेड. व्हेयर आर यू गोइंग? अरे आपको पता नहीं है, आपका महान पिताजी इतना बड़ा यज्ञ कर रहे हैं, विशाल यज्ञ दक्ष प्रजापति, और आपको पता नहीं है, ये कौन सी बात है? आपको तो पता नहीं है. बोला हाँ, बात सत्य है, आपके पिता के ही घर में जा रहे हैं. So then they said, even all your sisters are coming. Your 15 sisters are going to be there. Let's go. Then she knows what has happened originally. She said, I'll go to Lord Shiva. I will ask him. And if he says okay, then Lord Shiva says, Sati, why do you want to go? You know the situation there. And if you would be okay by going there, I didn't have any problem. I know your heart also.